Where was the land of Ophir, O-P-H-I-R, which is mentioned in the Bible?
Okay. Well, Thomas, this is the opportunity to understand how we can understand things. Number one is we go to the biblical text. Number two, we go to archaeology, and then we go to geography so that we can know what we can know. Ophir is in Genesis, in the 10th chapter of Genesis, which is considered to be the Table of Nations. Ophir is named as one of the sons of Yoktan. The book of Kings and Chronicles tells of a joint expedition to Ophir by King Solomon and Hiram out of Tyre. And it left from Etzion-Geber, which is next to a lot, on the Yam Suf. It's actually, Etzion-Geber is a seaport on the Yam Suf, which is now called the Gulf of Aqaba. In the Bible, it's the Red Sea crossing. But, you know, Red Sea, Reed Sea, I don't care what you call it in Hebrew. It is Yam Suf, only one body of water. And that is where they left from that port, that seaport, and went down to Ophir, okay? A later expedition by King Jehoshaphat failed when the ships were destroyed near the port at Etzion-Geber. And so he was on his way down to Ophir, and the entire fleet was wiped out. Now, as far as on the archaeological record, in 1946, there was a pottery shard that was found in Tel Kassil, which is modern-day Tel Aviv, and this dated back to the 8th century before the Common Era, and it bore the ancient Paleo-Hebrew inscription, 30 shekels of gold from Ophir for Beth Horon. So we know it is reality, but yet, its location still remained unknown. Now, as far as geography, the Israelis, when they took the Sinai Peninsula from Egypt in the Six-Day War, they had a settlement near Sharm el-Sheikh, which is right down where the Gulf of Aqaba narrows down, and then it opens up into the larger, what is called the Red Sea today. And they built a city down there, the Israelis, and called the city Ophira, which is the Hebrew for toward Ophir, since its location was on the Gulf of Aqaba, Yom Suf, and it was on the route of King Solomon's ships that went down there. So, you know, that's all we know, unless there's somebody else that knows more about it. But, you know, and again, just this is an example. You have ask a biblical question, you know, where is it? Okay, so this is what we have to explore to find out what we can know about it. So, unfortunately, if you're looking for gold, you're not gonna find it in Ophir because I can't tell you where it is, but I know it's here. It's in the chronological gospels. That's where you find the gold.